Morning watchers of my videos. Wow, it'll have to work. I'm just doing this video just to, do a quick update on where I'm at with all the vehicles, where the Supra is at, because I got a call on the way here that I wasn't too happy about. So first off, we are in Terrace, British Columbia, about a 15-hour drive from Edmonton, Alberta. And the RS is right there. And we just finally cleaned it from all the bug guts and all the rain crap. So drove on the Highway of Tears for the first time. And if you don't know what the Highway of Tears are, it's the highway where a lot of women have been abducted. And they are still cold cases, mostly. So if you want to Google that, it's a pretty weird highway to be on. And then we were driving on it and there were still people hitchhiking, so it's just like, you know, we don't fix the problem as time goes on, which is kind of weird. But the RS was awesome on the way here. Did some spirited driving through the mountains and the twisty roads, and really experienced what the car is all about, so I'm excited to take it potentially on our next rally. That would be really fun. And not stock intake exhaust tune would be nice on that thing, around 400 horse, 420 horse. It was awesome the way it is, but the only complaint I have personally of it is the seats are a little firm for my liking, but that's probably because it's new, but they sure hold you in place, so that's awesome. So the Supra, on the way here, we got a call from the body shop. They cannot match my paint whatsoever. It's a one-off. They think that's one of the main reasons that it was a SEMA car was the paint job. And they can't get the flake to replicate, so the car would just look weird. So I had to bite the bullet and get a whole paint job done, but I'm happy because that's what I wanted done originally. I wanted it all Baltic blue, all factory, with the exception of the TRD wing and the RMM lip. So it's all going back Baltic blue. Paint code 752, so I'm really happy about that. And we're gonna be putting the engine back in hopefully over winter, and it'll be, 600 horsepower and the way I want my car to look. So pretty stoked about that. And I also got a new winter beater. It's a vehicle I've wanted for quite some time, but they're so expensive, and they are miled right out, and they're still like 6K, so I found a good one. And I'll do a video on that. And just wanted to do a quick update. The RS right now is getting 21.8 miles per gallon average. So it's not too bad. That's like right around where they advertise it, and it's loaded up with gear and luggage. So it's not bad. But like I said, I'd really like just, I don't know, probably like 50 to 80 more horsepower in that thing would just be, you know, flawless. But the car handles amazing in those twisties, and does good decently on gas mileage, and it's comfortable for the most part. So we're really happy with it, and I love the way it looks more and more. So yeah, the only problem with it is that back hatch, when you clean it, it gets instantly dirty, so you have to bring it back home and kind of detail the back hatch every single time. I don't know what it is about. Though just the wind brings up the water and the dirt. So, but yeah, that's all I have to say right now. So hope you enjoyed the video as much as you can. I mean, it's a vlog, and I'll do a video soon on the winter beater. So that's it for this video, and I hope you liked it. So please like and subscribe. Bye for now.